You're insane.
You have spent your entire career trying to convince people that there are things all around them that they can't see. But when I give you the ability to bring those things to light, you act like a scared fucking child.
You just killed someone.
Thank you for your perspective, Dr. Moore. I believe you should take the rest of the day off.
Dr. Moore, first of all, happy holidays. Second of all, I heard you and your wife separated, so my sincere sympathies, of course. 3 weeks ago, you left the facility with a sample of the remains of Subject 2, a human test subject that we killed using your near-field antenna, the device you built with my family's money.
No, you probably figured out by now.
We let you leave. Are you hearing the voices yet, Jack? My great-grandmother was host to those voices in 1913. She was the door through which they came into Silverwood. Regardless, your son Caleb's home from college, we hear. He is a bright young man. It would be a shame to see his light snuffed out. But that is not going to happen now, is it? Because tonight, as he sleeps, you are going to take that pistol that you keep hidden under your pillow, and you are going to protect him in the only way left that you can. Your actions assure your son's safety. Thank you, Dr. Moore. Thank you for everything. And goodbye.
What is your name?
Will you help me?
Yes. I am here to help you.
We're ready, Dr. Rossi.
What are you doing to me?
Liam, I need you to focus.
This will cause some discomfort.
I am Christina Rossi, last of the Silverwood bloodline!